Imagine your digital keys, all those passwords you use every day, suddenly need a new home.
Yeah, that's pretty much the situation for anyone using Microsoft Authenticator for password storage and autofill right now.
Because come August 2025, that feature is just gone.
Exactly. Microsoft's making a clear move here. They want you using their Edge browser for passwords instead.
Right. But, you know, what if you don't want to switch to Edge? What are the other options? That's what we need to figure out today to make sure everyone has a smooth transition.
Okay, so the core issue, the bottom line, is this shift in focus for Microsoft Authenticator. It's going back to basics, you could say.
Meaning just the authentication part.
Precisely. Just multi-factor authentication, those one-time codes, passkeys, that sort of thing. The password manager side is being phased out.
And there's a clear timeline for this phase out, isn't there?
Oh, yeah. Very firm. By June next year, so June 2025, you won't be able to save any new passwords in Authenticator.
Okay, step one. Then what?
Then July 2025 hits. Autofill stops working completely. And importantly, any payment info you had saved in there, gone.
Ouch. And the final deadline?
August 2025. That's when all the saved passwords become totally inaccessible within the app itself. Poof.
So Microsoft's reasoning is basically centralization, keeping it all within the Edge browser.
That's their stated reason. They say your saved passwords, your addresses, all that stuff will sync securely with your Microsoft account if you're using Edge.
Allowing continued access and the autofill function people rely on.
Right. It's a very clear strategy to get more people using Edge as their main password vault.
So, choices. It seems like it boils down to two main paths initially.
Pretty much. Sure. Path one. You embrace the Microsoft ecosystem. You migrate your passwords to Edge.
Which means installing Edge on your phone, your tablet, everywhere, and making sure sync is turned on.
Exactly. Path two. You decide not to use Edge for passwords. In that case, you absolutely must export your passwords from Authenticator.
And that export needs to happen before August 1st, 2025. That's the critical date.
Cannot stress that enough. That export file is your ticket out. It lets you move your data to another application and avoid losing everything.
And just to be super clear, the Authenticator part, the codes, the MFA stuff,
yeah,
that keeps working in Microsoft Authenticator.
Yes, absolutely. That core function isn't going anywhere. This change is only about the password storage and autofill features.
Okay, good. So our goal here is really to guide you, the listener, through some reliable, secure alternatives. We want to make sure you're not caught scrambling at the last minute.
Let's start with the most direct alternative they're pushing, Microsoft Edge itself.
Right. The integration with the Microsoft account is obviously its main selling point. Secure syncing, autofill.
It provides all that, yes. The big question for users is, are you comfortable relying entirely on Edge, on Microsoft's ecosystem, for managing something this critical?
That's a really good point. Vendor lock-in is always something to consider, especially with security.
For those who maybe aren't comfortable with that or just prefer other tools, exporting is step one, that August deadline again.
And that export usually gives you what? A file, right?
Typically a CSV file. Think of it like a little digital suitcase holding all your login details, ready to be unpacked by another password manager.
Which brings us nicely to those other password managers. Many even bundle Authenticator features now, don't they?
They do. A really popular free one is Google Authenticator. It's, you know, widely compatible, works offline, pretty simple setup.
And didn't they recently add Cloud Sync? That was a big missing piece for a long time.
They did. You can now sync your codes with your Google account, which makes switching phones so much easier. That was a major pain point before.
Okay, what else? I know Authy is another big name.
Authy, yeah, by Twilio. It's known for being quite user-friendly, but also secure. Its big things are encrypted backups and multi-device sync.
So you can have it on your phone, tablet, computer.
Exactly. Easier recovery if you lose a device. The only slight catch is it needs a phone number for registration, which some privacy-focused users might not love.
Got it. What about integrated solutions? Like, if you already use a password manager...
Well, if you're a Bitwarden user, their Bitwarden Authenticator is a fantastic option. Bitwarden itself is open source, which is a big plus for transparency.
And it keeps the TOTP codes right there in your vault.
Right alongside your passwords. It consolidates things nicely. Very secure, very convenient if you're already in that ecosystem.
Then there are the premium options, like 1Password.
Yeah, 1Password is a really polished experience. It combines top-tier password management with built-in 2FA code generation, great interface, seamless syncing.
But it's a paid service.
It is, though they usually offer a free trial so you can, you know, kick the tires and see if it fits your needs.
What about options for people really focused on privacy, maybe open source?
AuthE-Auth is a really interesting one there. It's open source, focuses heavily on end-to-end encrypted sync.
Works offline too.
Works offline, supports multiple devices. It's a strong choice if open source and privacy are your top priorities.
Okay, so that covers managers that include authentication. But what if you pick a password manager that doesn't have that built in, or you just want to keep them separate? You still need an app for those codes.
Right, and like we said, Microsoft Authenticator itself will still do that job just fine.
Yeah.
No need to switch if you don't want to.
But if you do want to switch that part too,
then Google Authenticator and Authy are still great options, as we discussed. Another one is Duo Mobile.
Isn't that more for businesses?
It's often used in businesses, yeah. But it works perfectly well for personal TOTP codes too. Very reliable.
Any other free or open source ones just for codes?
FreeOTP is a solid choice. Totally free, open source, no ads, works offline. Very straightforward. And AuthE-Auth, which we mentioned, also works purely as a TOTP app.
We should probably mention desktop options too, right? Not everyone wants this just on their phone.
Good point. For Windows users, there's WinAuth. It lets you manage your 2FA codes right from your PC.
Compatible with the big services, Google, Microsoft, Steam.
Yeah, works with most common ones. It's handy if you do most of your logging in from your computer.
And then there's the really high security option, hardware keys.
Right. Things like YubiKey or other keys using FIDO2 or WebAuthn standards. This is kind of the gold standard for authentication security.
Like a physical key for your online accounts. Very hard to compromise.
Extremely strong security. Often enables passwordless login too. They work with more and more services, including Microsoft 365. Definitely something to consider if security is paramount.
Okay, so lots of options. Let's try to synthesize this a bit. Maybe some recommendations based on different needs?
Sure. For, let's say, simple personal use, maybe you don't need all the bells and whistles.
Yeah, just basic reliable codes.
Google Authenticator is a solid free choice there. Or free OTP if you strongly prefer open source and no frills.
What if you use multiple devices, phone, tablet, maybe a work computer, and want backup?
And Authy is really good because of its encrypted backups and multi-device sync. Or, if you want it all integrated, Bitwarden with its built-in authenticator is excellent.
And for maybe a small business setting or someone who just wants that extra layer of security.
Duo Mobile has features often geared towards organizations, so that could be a fit. But really, for top-tier security, hardware keys like YubiKey are the way to go.
And finally, for the privacy purists and open source fans.
AuthE-Auth and FreeOTP stand out there. Both are open source. AuthE-Auth has that encrypted sync focus.
So the main takeaway here, the really crucial message, is don't put this off. August 2025 sounds far away, but it'll creep up.
Absolutely. Start exploring these alternatives now. Figure out what makes sense for you.
Whether that's moving over to Edge, choosing a dedicated password manager that also handles authentication, or keeping them separate with a dedicated authenticator app.
Understanding your options now is key. It ensures you keep access to everything and maintain that security posture without any last-minute panic.
It really comes down to thinking about how you use the internet, what devices you use, and what your personal security comfort level is, right?
Exactly. Which of these tools and approaches feels like the best fit for your digital life? Maybe spend a little time looking into the ones that caught your interest during this chat.
And just a reminder, this deep dive reflects the information we have as of today, May 6th, 2025. Things can always change, of course.
Indeed. If you found this exploration useful, please do check out more deep dives on the podcast de Philippe.
Yeah, and maybe help us reach our goal of 1,000 subscribers. We'd really appreciate it.